Hello everyone! In this video I'm going to speak about combined style of table tennis. When you play near the table, try to confuse your opponent with disruptive balls from your pips out and destroy his game. On the other side, there is a pips in or pips out for attack, with which you can attack to win points. And if you go far from the table or serve high ball, you start defending with disruptive pips out. Now some backstory for you to understand better and not to waste a lot of time for experiments with rubbers like I did. I played UP2 soft forehand and medium pips Dr. Neubauer KO 1 and 3 mm and I did great. KO were very disruptive, opponents made mistakes. But I got bored with it. I was chopping and pushing with KO both near and far from the table. I rarely attacked and did it without confidence, because I haven't learned to do that. So I used only 50% of what KO is capable of. Because I've never practiced playing with it, I only played tournaments. Recently I played with medium pips, which have more grip, so it was easy to drive and block. I started playing KO at the tournament without any practice. It's undesirable to risk at the tournament, you need to give it all. So I played chopping and pushing only. It was enough for me to win enough matches, but I quickly get bored and I decided to find the pips out, which allow me pushing to make opponents mistake and driving as well. I wanted to both attack and block, so I started trying lots of pips out. I tried varied medium pips with different sponges: 1.5, 1.3, 1.2, 1.1, 0.5, and even Dr. Neubauer Aggressor OX. I also tried short pips with various grip, from very grippy Dermaterial Specialist Firestorm to Dr. Neubauer Killer, which has a little friction, from 2 to 1 and 2 mm. I also tried Gipfelsturm, even tried long pips OX. All these rubbers were good and I liked most of the pips, especially long pips OX. But they all were not too disruptive like KO. Apparently, if pips out allow attacking and blocking, they are less disruptive and destructive than KO. I've tried different pips out for a very long time and my patience has run out. I thought long pips OX by Inhe are good for me. They are not fast, are hard and have light grip. They are disruptive, but not too much. You can play a lot of moves near the table. It is good. I had some match play and decided to compare them with KO 1 and 3 mm. After I put them on, my opponent started making mistakes. I felt I am missing that feeling when opponent makes mistakes. Then I tried them one more time with other opponent and he said that they were the most difficult pips out to play against. So I found out that the most disruptive pips out in TT Maximum Sharp are medium pips Dr. Neubauer KO. I put a lot of work to find it out. I experienced a lot of losses. If someone told me before that KO are the most disruptive rubber, I'd not believe it. I'd think there might be some better pips out. Now I see that KO 1 and 3 mm are the most disruptive and effective pips to destroy opponent's game and attack. But the rubber requires good technique. If you want to push and chop only, it's not hard to play. I did it easily. But if you want to master KO and unleash hell on your opponent, you need to practice a lot. Because when you block or attack with drive, the ball can either overfly or slip into the net. It doesn't mean it has no control. No. If you play it with pips in or short pips, it will be hard for you to start playing with KO. But it's to my mind. If you used to play with grippy long pips with a sponge like Inhe Neptune, it will be hard for you to start playing with KO as well. If you used to play with long pips or X, it will be easy for you to learn again to play with KO. I think it's worth it. I block and attack with drive or smash sometimes, and I see it is very effective. You'd better spend some time to master KO to play push, chops, blocks, attack with drive or smash. Also learn the tactics. I think using the whole range of moves will make opponents recognize you from afar and damn you. Recently, Dr. Neubauer presented KO 1 and 0 and 6 mm, and they are already delivered to TT Maximum Shop. It'll be interesting to try them. If you are interested in details about playing with KO, there are reviews of KO 1 and 3, 1.5 and 2 mm on TT Maximum channel. The links are below. That's all about KO. I want to add a few words about other disruptive pips out for playing near the table. I can compare their disruption because haven't tried them all, but I heard a lot of them and want to mention them. Zauer and Roger Hellfire, Zauer and Roger Hellfire X, Tipha Grass Detects, Dr. Neubauer Viper Soft. As far as I know, these long pips or X are one of the most disruptive long pips near the table. If you know more disruptive pips, let us know in the comments below. You can buy pips mentioned in the video using the links below. Buying in our shop is always a good way to thank us for our videos, if you like them or find them useful. Don't forget to like and share our videos. Subscribe and hit the notification bell not to miss new videos. At last, I want to remind that we make videos to help you save time and money, so you can learn more about rubbers and blades you're interested in and see what can suit you best, or help you prevent from buying unsuitable equipment. In the TT Maximum shop, there are a lot of filters and characteristics to help you learn more. So visit our site or contact us if you need help with choosing. We'll gladly help to choose the right equipment.